Hello everybody and welcome back. So as you know that we were discussing about grief model and we have already covered three stages. So today we'll be covering the next two stages that are depression, okay? That are depression and the last stage we'll be covering today is acceptance. Now we have already covered denial stage, we have covered the anger stage, bargaining stage, and I have already told you the coaching advices as well. So today we'll be starting with the stage 4, that is depression. Now remember that you are not out of the woods quite yet, okay? So after the bargaining phase is over, remember that there is one more dip in the curve. Okay, the learning phase may not always be very happy, may always not be very comfortable zone for most of the employees of a workplace. As we know that for every employee, you know, learning is not very a happy thing. Okay, they may feel very uncomfortable also while learning new things. So remember that this is again going to be a major dip in the curve. Okay, so employees may have, but always remember that employees, you know, they realize by this time that now that there is no way out of the situation. Okay, so that may result in low morale, and then again it may result in, you know, low energy, and you won't imagine that even it can result into depression at times. Okay, it may result into depression at times. Now team members, you know, they are stuck in this stage. They, you know, display many signs of indifference, and at times they push even others away. So this is a low energy phase, and it requires again a lot of support to renew feelings of motivation. Okay, so in this stage they will definitely show that there will be many signs of indifferences. Okay, they will have a low energy, they will be less motivated, they will not be happy. Obviously, some employees will be happy with this stage. They will be very happy, you know, happily they will be bringing the change in themselves. But some employees, they will be opposing the change, they will be resisting it. They will be unhappy with it, they will be uncomfortable with it. So the coaching advice given at this stage is that it is very important for the management to understand that this phase is not easy for the team. This phase is not easy for the team. At this stage, the managers can make the training sessions more exciting. The more exciting the training can be made, the better would it be for the employees to move ahead. The better they will move ahead, will obviously they will give better results. Okay, so the employers can give training, they can make training very exciting. Okay, so the employees can move ahead and give their best. So apply positive feedback in the learning process and definitely motivate your employees of the organization with some awards or rewards or maybe some recognition also. So motivation is also required at this stage. Okay, so this was basically stage number 4. So the last stage is acceptance. Okay, now at this stage when people realize that fighting the change that is coming into their life is not going to make the grief go away. Definitely we all know that. Obviously, you know, they'll know that if you'll fight for a particular kind of change that you know that is obviously coming in your organization, there is no way out. Okay, so that is the change that is coming into their life is not going to make the grief go away. So they resign to the situation. At times they resign to the situation and then they accept it completely. They resign that we cannot change the situation, we need to adapt the change, we need to learn the new change, and they try to accept it completely with wholeheartedly. Okay, so this stage is the one you have been waiting for. Obviously this is the stage that all the employers, all the managers, team leads, project heads, they are like really waiting for this stage to happen. Okay, so this is where the change starts to become second nature, and then, you know, the people, the employees of the organization, they embrace the improvements to the way they have worked previously. Okay, so this stage, the fifth stage of acceptance, this is a very happy stage for the employers, for the managers. Okay, so the coaching advice for this stage is that managers, you know, they will finally begin to see the benefits of the hard work they had put in so far. Okay, they'll try to see that, you know, they'll have a wow factor, obviously. They'll see, they'll, you know, this is a quote in English that you sow what you reap, right? So this is a stage. Now the team is, you know, the team is showing improvements. Okay, the team is showing improvements now. The team has started putting in the efforts, and then you will see that the overall productivity of the organization has increased, or you can say that it has begun to improve. Okay, so remember here, the very important thing to remember here is to repeat it, to repeat this procedure and reinforce objectives. Okay, the very first thing is to repeat it and reinforce objectives and strategy, and make sure to share successes with the team. Make sure that you share success with the team. Every effort that every individual is doing, every individual, every employee is contributing, remember that you should share the success of individual team member to whole of the organization, because then only they're going to reinforce it. Positive reinforcement comes into the picture, comes into the organization. So definitely this is now the time to celebrate, and then from here you can move towards a brighter future also. Okay, so this is all about the five stages of grief model. Okay, so we started with denial. Okay, the very first thing, if you see this diagram here, the very first thing that you can see here is obviously stability. Stability is before the change came in the organization. That is before the change came in the organization. We were all stable. All employees, all teams, departments were working very smoothly. They were in a stable condition. Then when they, in their knowledge, when it comes that a change is going to come in the organization, and then, you know, there is something new that they have to learn, then they try to immobilize, right? They try to immobilize that a change is coming, and then we need to, we'll be learning new things, and they'll be start immobilizing things. And then the stages come. The very first stage was denial, second anger, third bargaining, fourth depression, fifth was acceptance. Before acceptance, there are some companies that go through testing stage, that is the change really beneficial for all? Is the change pouring us some benefits or not? Okay, so they go through, they undergo through the test, and then the final stage is acceptance. You know, acceptance is just like, wow, this stuff actually worked, and I'm actually creating new ways of solving problems, new ways of organizing work, and understanding. I have good understanding of customer now. Of course, this is the final objective, and it is wonderful to see people create new ideas based on the concepts that were part of the change. Okay, so couple of we can see a couple of examples. Okay, even you can put some example, successful examples in front of your another employees. They can also these examples will obviously help them transform an entire organization. Okay, again, this is not a linear process. Okay, this is not a linear process. You know, if I talk about the best technique by far is to empathize with the emotions of change. Okay, then be positive. Okay, empathize with the change, empathize with the employees, and then be positive, and then be encouraging, and then reinforcement should be done, and after reinforcement is done, acceptance will take place. So this was all about the models of organizational change that we have covered. This was basically your last model. Okay, so now this topic is completed. Thank you.